Yeah, well, the exhibition is called Radical Pedagogies, Action, Reaction, Interaction, and it's a really global study of the significance of radical pedagogies in the post-war years, which affects not only Italy but the rest of the world. So in this context of Mondo Italia, we also wanted to open up the understanding of Italy. It's fascinating that in the post-war years, there's already a kind of a diaspora of Italians. You find Italians all over the world, practically like now. And perhaps this is why this is a moment also of great innovation also in Italy. Italians are significantly affect the education also in Spain, where I study. Tafuri, the Tendenza, all of them come to Spain. So you can say that this is a moment of great circulation and exchange of ideas that makes this moment very interesting. So the exhibition is based on this research on pedagogy. It pays enormous attention to Italy and to the experiments that took place in Italy, but also Italians abroad and other people coming to Italy, and in the world also there is a lot of examples that are not necessarily Italians, right? Because you have to see Italy also in the context of a worldwide kind of explosion of experiments in radical pedagogy. We didn't want to do an exhibition that was provincially focused only on Italy, but precisely on an Italy that is now occupying a global stage. Yes, that was incredibly important for us. It's, the exhibition is open source in the sense that all the research that we have done with the PhD students at Princeton for over 3 years is now there, available for anybody who is doing a PhD, who wants to do more research, to look at the documents, etc. But we are also very interested in contributions from visitors to the wall and to the exhibition. So, for example, Massimo Scolari was just in the exhibition and was telling me about other case studies, other people that have been in Atlanta, other experiments. And this has happened the whole time that I'm in the Biennale. Chris de Korn, the director of Tate, passed by yesterday, and he said, you know, there was a little group in Brussels that maybe you should include. So I invited him to contribute. And we want the world to be an interactive world in which people take information but also provide information and make their own story. That's why also the kind of complication that the upper part is organized by longitude, geographical, and the other part is chronological, creates a little bit of a disconnect that makes your brain also to start making different kinds of connections which are your own, and this is very important to us, that you make your own story. Yes, well, of course, Italy is, you know, I studied in Barcelona and I learned Italian before I learned English. I didn't think that English was that important in those years as Italian was. I learned Italian to read the Tafuri in the original. The impact of Italy in Barcelona was enormous, not only in design but also in history and theory. A very significant part of the exhibition is the augmented reality. So we have an app, and every time you see a little kind of iPhone sign, you can put your iPad or your iPhone or whatever phone you have, a smartphone, on top of one of those images, and then more information comes to you, like newsreels and more photographs and more documents and films, etc. So the exhibition is physical, is here, but at the same time it opens also to other spaces. That is important because, in fact, the name radical comes actually from Germano Celand, who invented this term to talk about radical design of these periods. In the last few years, there has been an enormous amount of attention to the question of design in the radical period, but nobody seemed to have realized how significant was the pedagogy. And so there was a kind of, you can say, a pedagogical turn in the post-war years, and really Italy contributed enormously to this pedagogy.
Thank you very much.